Okay, so we need to up our instability. Let's take one Praetorian Guard that's pretty free. Double Frail Constitution probably as well. One Adaptation is basically free, and then the Damned gets us up to 40. Throw in Maximum Eroding Sanity. What else do we want here? I guess we'll need some Festering Scars. I could max out on Festering Scars and get back to somewhere else. You know what, actually? Here's a fun idea. Since Ritual is a card that exists now, what if I actually just try maxing out on Original Sin? How's that do? Try something like this? Let's try something like this. This is a little different than what I usually do. We'll do She this time. Probably still the better of the two starting decks, I think. But not by a ton. Okay, Escalate, that's very good. We'll need that for the Void. Persist is going to be really nice as well. Combo Strike is fine. It's a pretty good Future Strike card. I'm just going to roll the Concentrate. Opposing Force. Okay. I think Better Future is probably the pick here. No Mirror Guard. Mirror Guard is like my go-to, but Better Future is pretty good for the starting deck. What are we looking at here? Couple of interesting options. Another Persist. Reach Through Time's a pretty fun card. Let's see about picking these ones up. Okay, they're all clustered at the end here. Interesting. We also need to hit the Shrine. It looks like going up and around like that is probably going to be ideal, which means we'd miss the Persist and the Ice Wall. I suppose it's not absolutely necessary that we go to the Shrine. Although we would still have to pick between the Elite and the Card Pack in that case. Path would look like this. We get Trance, Quick Escape, Calm. Could do this instead. That seems reasonable. A lot of upgrades. 1, 2, 3, 4 upgrades. A little bit sketchy. To start, I'm definitely gonna put the Purple Stone in a stability. cut one deflection for a better future. Cut the stillness for combo strike. And I should probably play Jack of All. Just looking at this. Seems decent. Persist will come in later. Once the fights are lasting longer and the fatigue's more relevant. Ah, the tea leaves. Yeah, I don't think so. Five souls. I mean, we might offer souls at the Dark Idol. And we have the Damned on, so we have 5 plus 6 plus 7. So I think I actually do just want 5 souls here. Get a nice relic at the idol. We'll give that a try. Definitely gonna feel these voids until we get rid of them. I'm gonna be looking for a ritual in the chest. We only get one chest, right? Yeah, just one. We have to fight one elite with all of them. And then we have a whole bunch of free nodes. So all things considered, it's actually not that bad. There's probably a way to use discipline to avoid triggering the beads there, but we'll just set it back up at least a little bit. Health potion, that's nice as a safety net. The first upgrade could well be better future. Escalate will be upgraded eventually, but it's not even going to be in the deck for a good while. Opposing Force is an interesting option. I think I will just do Better Future. It's a pretty big upgrade, getting the extra vision. Yeah, hands like this are going to happen. No really good way to use the spell here. I guess that's just that. We got the beads ready, we're just gonna hope. Hope the things work out. Okay. Better future with the beads and even combo strike. Although it's not actually very convenient to go Zen here. I could do the spell first. That seems like the best play, actually. Spell back a stability. And then we'll go Jack. Combo. Stability. And then we probably want to purge this. Put back some defense. Not that we actually have all that much to put back here, because I don't want to do double discipline. But I guess one repeating deflection, one discipline works. Hopefully. Okay, yeah, that's fine, that's fine. Massive amount of delay block, actually get some use out of the rage. I'll just pick you off, you're mostly dead already. the game is just set up beads. And then the real test is just going to be this fight. Can we handle that with triple voids? Dang, we actually can't go Zen here without killing him. Would have really liked to have the beads ready to go for the next fight. Okay, speaking of the next fight, what upgrade is going to help us the most? This is a tough call. Discipline for more block? I feel like I should take a defensive upgrade. We have a yellow stone that's probably going into stability. Echo Wall could be pretty decent too, honestly. Could be a lot of reflected damage. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna try this opposing force. We're gonna see where that gets us. Before I socket the Yellowstone, we'll just check out the chest. Hoping for a ritual. No. Centipede stance, though. That's a pretty good one. We can get it back with the better future. Don't think there's any other vision guaranteed, though. Well, actually, Reach Through Time could get us back better future, which could get us back centipede stance. I guess. It's a cool card, it's a new card, but I don't think I can take it. I think I need the shield wall. We gotta boost our defenses. And I might even just upgrade the shield wall. I think that's what I'm gonna do, actually. Need better defense. Okay. So, given that we still have all three voids, I don't want to cut any stabilities. It's important that they're two attacks in one for going Zen. So for the time being, I'm actually going to... I don't know, man. Am I actually going to cut a stability? I want the opposing force in, of course. Jack of all trades is good because it blocks. Combo strike is good because it draws. I guess I'll swap out the combo strike. We will put this on a stability, just to get the double trigger. Cut a repeating deflection for a shield wall. I'm okay with not being able to go Zen with abilities super reliably if we're keeping in all these stabilities to go Zen with attacks. Persist is probably going to be pretty good in this fight. I think this is the setup here. And Aegis is probably going to be the best option as well. Cultist Ward, again, we skipped on the Centipede stance. There's a no condo coming up. Reach Through Time. This does some stuff. But it's pretty easy to fill up the Aegis charges. And the blocks that we do have are very chunky, right? We have the Shield Wall. We still are running both stabilities. I guess doubling the Jack of All Trades is pretty bad. Doubling the Better Future is... potentially pretty good. I think I should take the Aegis. If I had like Squid Stance or something, then I'd be more interested in the Cultist Ward. But no more chests, no card shop or anything, just the pack. Okay, yeah, Aegis. Starting out with an attack here. Get ourselves some delay block. Keep the shield wall since it blocks everything. I'm gonna try to make very careful use of my spell this fight. Okay, good to see the overcharge. That's gonna help a lot. And I think the play here is just gonna be shield wall and then put it back. Unfortunately, couldn't get the use out of the rage there since I wanted to go Zen with the attacks and then play the shield wall for the discount. Okay, so the opposing force is going to be pretty good here. Better future, huh? So obviously the block is wasted, but just keep getting back the shield wall. That seems good. We have only two stabilities left in the deck and two voids. Okay, that kind of sucks. What I wanted to do was to get this guy back and goes in with attacks, but it's kind of unlikely that we draw one of these stabilities if we're putting back two other cards on top that aren't attacks. I mean, I guess we are going to be getting a bunch of hitting deflections. The shield is going to be ready. Also could just take some damage. Like, if we're doubling this, that's 12 block. Plus 8 from the stability that we're playing, that's 20. I mean, that's pretty good. But that's only if we draw the discipline. I probably shouldn't be greedy about this. So I think we just put back shield wall and honestly this stability if that's the case. I'll just take the overcharge. If I'm only going to be playing it once potentially, I think I'd rather get the overcharge than the four block. Yeah, okay, no stability draw. Okay, so finally we have an off turn. This thing's charged up. Excellent hand. Just phenomenal. Okay, spell is off cooldown again, though. Thank the Lord. So we'll just put that back. We have plenty of mana. We're going to be double triggering this, so that's all of our block taken care of. Very unexciting turn, but should be fine. Oh my god. Okay, not going Zen with any of this stuff, so we'll just double the shield wall. And I guess we'll just go for maximum delay block, jeez. This is rough, man. Okay, beads are ready though, we're blocking like half of this damage. Okay, the yellow stability, that's appreciated. This has been a very slow fight. We're gonna take a little bit here. He's getting very close to dead. This time, we have plenty of attacks left, so I am gonna go for the Yellowstone stability shield wall plan. I could even hold this if I wanted to be greedy, but I think I need the energy more. 2 HP, not a huge deal. Okay, this hand looks pretty good. Barely alive, you see that little sliver of green? Luckily, we didn't have to waste our Aegis, though. Just one charge under. And anything does it now. Okay. Great fight, man. That went about as well as I could have hoped with three voids in the deck, and not the most powerful setup we've got here. But should be getting a nice boost, because we're about to get all of the voids out, plus a rare relic there. Can't afford any of this. I won't buy anything here unless it's a draw potion. That's a stealth potion. Ah, yes, this one, the new Enlightened potion. This one's pretty cool. Getting one free fatigue on everyone is actually kind of a huge deal. Like, this is potentially something that you put in for the void. Currently, I just have the health pot. We're getting one, two more. I almost want to buy this, but don't know, man. I guess I should save my money, because I'd be just as happy with a brew draw potion. And depending on the direction this deck goes, maybe the stealth potion would be really good, maybe the rage potion would be really good. You can only brew one potion, so... Given that there are so many potentially strong options that are, like, maybe comparable with this fatigue potion, we're gonna say no. We're also gonna say no to the potential secret room, because I have collapsing hallways. Don't want to take 5 damage. My health is also only going to be healed up to 25%, right? Oh no, it's 75%. Maybe I could have taken the 5 damage there. Anyway, this is why we took the starting souls bonus. Ooh, that is a really good one for Enlightened. No changes to make here. Do have this redstone. Where does the redstone go? I don't have a clue. I guess I could go on a stability. Just, you know, that's kind of the boring answer. Nothing else is really calling out to me, though. Could probably wait until the card pack. We'll try and do that. Okay. Got the opposing force here. Does something. yeah, let's put you down at the bottom. We might need you by the time we draw back around. And why not just get all the block we need? Oh, actually, that was really excessive with the Aegis. Whoops. I'm not too worried about this fight, though. Let's put you on the bottom. Don't want both of the stoned stabilities in the same hand. Draw one. Persist, huh? You're not that good right now, man. Quite a few cards that make up the rest of the block, so we'll purge. I think this track is from Gimmick? Oh no, this track's from Plock. Yeah, this is the beach track from Plock. Classic. Okay, too many stabilities, right? These guys are on the bottom, so we want to put back one stability so that way we can go Zen with the attacks. This turn we'll get our block with better future, I guess. Maybe. I do kind of like the hand that I know is coming up, though. These 5, that's pretty good. So I guess I don't better future? Gets rid of all of our burning, too. Why not? Slightly energy inefficient. Oh, wait. Somehow I didn't account for that. I'm supposed to play the repeating deflection. It's fine. Let's get rid of you. I don't think we're going to cycle through the deck again. Six block there. I guess. Take 2 more just to try and... Actually, what am I trying to do with that play? There's a reason I had in mind. Probably shouldn't have done that. I'm still waking up, that's my excuse this time. We don't need you. Aegis will not be ready to go, but we are gonna draw a card. Alright, I'll go ahead and do this. Elite is next, so we want to... Oh wait, no, the Elite is not next. Okay, we don't really care that much about having the beads ready to go then. Can probably set them up over the course of the next fight. That is not one of the potions I was hoping for. That's fine, though. Are we getting a green stone anytime soon? We are. Might well go on the reach through time. It's a pretty good upgrade, saving the energy. Lots of vision is appreciated. Let's do it. Get the other void out of the deck. Get our card pack. What do we even cut for the reach through time? I guess a discipline. Get rid of an expensive card, put in a cheaper card that still helps us block. Seems pretty good. It's a real shame that the blue stones are so late, given that we have this quick escape. I don't think this card's gonna get used. You'll be live by the time we get back around to you. This is already 8 block. I think I can just purge this. Play literally anything alongside the stability. This way we only play 3 cards for the cursed clover. Okay, yeah, so we'll be blocking with a repeating deflection, which means we're going Zen like that. This is gonna be 6, actually. So I guess the plan is double the purple one, play this guy once. 6 from this is a full block, which means we don't really need you. Gets us plenty of delay block as well. I think we're actually just gonna purge the reach through time. Showed up a little too late for this fight. This is a quick fight. The echo wall damage on this guy, man. Halfway dead, and we didn't even do anything. Okay, this hand sucks. Oh, wow. 5 attacks next turn, too. Yo, that's bad. Yo, this is bad. Jeez, I guess, I mean, the delay block at least is... Okay, yeah, you know what? Let's put discipline. And then we'll just discard the better future. See what we draw here. We drew a stability, so that means that this is our hand next turn. This gets us the block. No, this gets us the block. Yeah. Oh, but that gives me the poison. Okay, I still need 3 block. Yeah, we'll just do it with the discipline then, which means I purge here. Echo Wall is unfortunately down at this point. It was an unusual choice that I made for me. Go with the opposing force upgrade. I just didn't really have anything better than that to contend it. It's felt pretty good. Okay, I guess we don't need you. Right. Yeah, let's put you back. We'll just get rage here. Honestly, I feel like we should just be going for damage here, so I'm gonna grab back the persist and get more rage. Very nearly killed you. I'm just gonna purge this guy, and I think we finish him off now with the persist draw. Jack plus repeating deflection is good enough. The plan for Zen probably doesn't involve the opposing force. I don't know, the opposing force actually is pretty good against you, though. Huh. I guess we don't need you, because the Jack is getting doubled. Are we even going to use the persist? Probably should, right? It's probably better than the stability, getting the draw. Okay. So we'll hit you like that, and then you're dead from Echo Wall. Okay, cool. Wrapped it up. Get out of here. Alright, show me something big in this booster pack. Thousand Fists, it's back. I'm not gonna say no, I don't think, right? Could be the redstone, could be the blackstone that we're getting. Reload is potentially very good as well. I guess maybe I roll the body in mind. We definitely can't support dumping a lot into an X cost card given the way that this deck is going. Oh, that's a good one. Okay, now I have to think about where my greenstone goes. We have a lot of interesting choices to make all of a sudden with our stones. Yeah, this deck just got revolutionized. Let's take out... I can probably take out one stability for 1,000 Fists at this point. The Jack of All is potentially getting cut in a bit here too. I think it's time to... well, I don't know. Discipline, you know, expensive blocks are better when we can double them for free, right? I definitely want the reload in. This will cut a repeating deflection. Run Ragged is definitely going in. Okay, I will cut the Jack of All for Run Ragged here. And so now we have the stones that are being considered. We have this red stone that we already own, the black stone we're about to get, and what we will eventually do with the green stone. 1,000 Fists would be good with red or black. Run Ragged would be potentially good with black. Although it's probably better with green if we don't see exactly the keys from this elite. If we are putting black stone on the Run Ragged, then the green stone could go on Reach Through Time. Tough choices. I don't think we ever put black stone on this, and we only put black stone on this if we see the keys. So in all likelihood, the black stone will be on 1,000 Fists then. That way we also don't have to put our black stone on this Escalate just to deal with the Void. Since it's kind of a waste in most other fights. Okay, no keys. Unfortunate. But, pretty good options. The red pills. Don't know how good the red pills actually would be. We are kind of doing quite a bit of blocking in the midst of our turn. Obsidian Crown is really good eventually if we line it up on the Run Ragged. The Raid sure is tempting though, man. We definitely are lacking damage right now. Definitely lacking on damage. I mean, the Run Ragged helps with that a lot, I guess. All of these have a strong case to be made for them. I think I might just try and take the red pills and high roll on my 1,000 Fists. I mean, it's not that good right now because it's unupgraded, but it'll be upgraded soon. Persist. Because, like, right now, you know, it's 28, which is still a lot better than 10. Miss out on our upgraded opposing force, which sucks a bit. That's okay, I wanted the overcharge. Because that way it's like, if I purge it, I gain one energy. If I play it, I gain the energy and I can sift out two random cards, basically. The faster we cycle through our deck, the faster we get back around to our damage dealers. Okay, so double stability for sure here. put back you. Can't play this thing yet either. We have yet to play this card, but it's too important that we run ragged here. Pretty likely to draw a shield wall, so we're just gonna send it. I wanted that stability so I could double dip on it and then persist. Guess we're doing Zen with abilities instead. In which case, I can better future the Thousand Fists so that it's upgraded. And I guess we'll put the reload there too. Oh, we're double. Man! We're double triggering it. I totally forgot about that. We had just enough charges. Oops. I guess let's put you and you then. Okay. Well, this turn should still be pretty good. What we don't need by now is the reload. We're going to draw it anyway, though. Yeah, okay, because here's the plan. Let's get rid of this. Hit you for 112. I was gonna double dip on this with the spell, but I guess we don't even need to. I could just use the spell to gain rage now. Yeah, okay. 128. So much damage on that card. It is really nice that the Better Future still lets us use it to full effect before we get it upgraded, because first upgrade would be at the Well of Stars. I don't quite think we're ready for no condo yet, but we could be eventually. If we're gonna be, if we get more stuff like the persist and the reload, cycle through the deck faster. Okay, at this point, I probably should decide where this Blackstone goes. We already saw no keys. I don't want to wait until I've fought whatever elites I'm going to fight on floor 2. As good as the double run ragged is, it's probably unnecessary most of the time. Can just 2,000 fists. And who knows, maybe we get like a Queen Stone or something for the run ragged. So we'll go Blackstone on the Thousand Fists. Redstone, still don't really know what I'm doing with it at this point. I should probably have made up my mind on that, and it's likely just a stability. So we'll do that, because this becomes a great way to enter Zen before playing a Thousand Fists. Getting the free rage. I really like how we keep drawing this persist early and then just getting to put it back with the card sharp. Very handy. We're just gonna hold the shield wall for next turn here. So I guess we're going shield wall, double repeating deflection for Zen. I mean, the Thousand Fists is actually not good right now, of course, but I don't want to put it on the bottom of my deck. I want to put it in the discard pile so that I can grab it with Better Future and make it useful. Does it reach through time again? No, I should probably put this on the bottom. You know, actually, maybe I just don't even go Zen, honestly, right? ton of block coming up. We said we don't want to play that already. Next turn is odd, so we would put back an attack. Let's finally play this thing, you know? We're pretty likely to get the Aegis up. In fact, I think it's guaranteed. Which means that this is 8, this is 6. This is a tough call here, how I want to spend the energy. I should probably play the Repeating Deflection. Echo Wall damage keeps stacking up. Okay, so this will actually go into the deck if we put it back. Don't want that. Beads are not ready, but we can... If we go Zen with attacks, the Aegis is good to go, which means we're double dipping on one of these. If we play this for 8, we need 5 more. Jeez. The energy situation here. So if we spend all of our energy on stabilities, everything else is free. In order to full block, we would then need to do double Better Future and the double Repeating Deflection, which means that we have to put back the Daze if we want to full block this turn, which I do. All these attacks. The Run Ragged, unfortunately, very low down in the draw pile. I guess the opposing force, we're probably going to purge it. Probably we're going to purge whatever we put back there. The options just weren't great. Okay. Right, so we have to go Zen like this. Putting a ton of cards on top is at least nice in that it delays the drawing of this Daze. So we're going to put back 4. One of them needs to be the Thousand Fists. I guess the order doesn't really matter because we're not drawing anymore on this turn. We absolutely want to have the Red Pill Rage, but that's already accounted for. So, Thousand Fists and the stability for Rage. I guess this maybe because it could get us extra Rage. These two cards don't matter that much, in truth. Because we're going Zen with this plus this into this. Thousand Fists. Okay, yeah, so I can play this, I think. Pretty sure this works out. We're gonna put another Daze down on the bottom. I guess we'll put this on top. I don't think it matters. So he goes in, we draw 1, and then that means purge, smack, yeah, okay. Easy. Super overkill. Skin potion. Yeah, none of the ones that I called out from earlier that would be really good have been found so far. Again, that's Rage, Stealth, Draw, and the Enlightened's class potion. Potion of Tranquility, I think it's called. Those are the ones we want to see. We have not seen any of them so far. Kind of mediocre potions. I guess the health pot is fine, you know, but it's not really what I was hoping for. No changes to be made here. Still not ready for this escalate. That escalate might not come in literally until the void, in truth. Hey, we got early reach through time for once here, huh? Unfortunately, seeing the better future this early is an issue, though. I guess we can get rid of it and grab it back with the reach through time. Because next turn will be even, for example, and so we can put it back. Yeah, that seems fine. Let's put you at the bottom, I guess. And we'll just go reach, purge all this stuff out. I guess I'll play this. Seems fine. Bit of a slow start. No curse ward, though, thank God. makes me much more accepting of my slow start, but this guy's still quite scary for Enlightened. We do need to handle him because we can't purge that much to handle the burning in the class that goes Zen. We'll just be blocking with the repeating deflection here so you can go to the bottom. We said we wanted to put Better Future back. So we know at this point two cards on the bottom, Better Future on the top. So pretty good odds of getting Thousand Fists and Run Ragged next turn. We'll go after this guy. Get our block. And at this point, yeah, I do want to draw the Better Future. Right, because this is exactly what I was hoping for. I dump you now, and I save this for next turn? Or do I? I was thinking 4 plus 5, perfect block, upgrade the Thousand Fists, but it might even be better just to do it now, honestly. So, we're gonna do that. And to handle that 4 block... This... I think this is on the bottom, right? I think we put this on the bottom. Gonna be drawing from these cards. None of those do block. How much does 3 block matter? Well, I just upgraded 5 block. Fine. Repeating deflection. We're not gonna have Red Pill Rage. The Banes could throw a wrench into things. This is getting weird. Run Ragged, man. This Greenstone's gonna be so good for it. I really don't want to have to put this Bane on the bottom. So I guess I won't. That's the obvious choice there. I guess we're going Zen with abilities, which is fine, sort of. We need the delay block. This will unhaunt us a lot. Kill you. So this is like our literal only block card right now. Stability, I think, is on the bottom, right? Oh, I should be like writing down which cards I put on the bottom or something. I do not remember. Crud, man. It's gonna be an even turn, so we're gonna be getting an ability back, which we can draw. I guess we're fine then. We still get burned on this turn, which sucks. We're up to 12 burning, that's real concern. Okay, yeah, it was on the bottom. The opposing force is actually not very good right now. Speaking of not very good, though, this hand in general. At least we can finally play the Run Ragged. Okay, let's put Shield Wall on the bottom. We get our vision. We need to block for 7. We have the double-double, so... Better Future. It'll be kind of like a Bend Fate. okay. You're already gonna die. We don't care that much about the fortitude. It just goes in this way. We don't want that. We don't want that. We do want that. Again, it'd be really nice if we could have Red Pill, but we can't. We just need to be playing the Thousand Fist anyway. So we're gonna put back 4. So this is our whole turn plus, I think this stability? But then there's the Banes as well getting thrown into the mix that we have to consider. So we should put the Thousand Fists last if we want to use it, right? So in that case, let's put these two last to try and get the Rage. We'll get this one. Yeah, okay, so we'll go Repeating Deflection to upgrade that one, Persist, the Stability that gives Rage, and then the Thousand Fists. Okay. Finally not gonna take any more burning. We might get hit for a little bit before we leave. I guess I can afford to put one Bane back this time. And we'll grab you, I guess. Okay. Stability. Stability. Stop being haunted. Persist to draw card. Should probably get the rage here. We're gonna take damage. That's okay. We heal for 75%. We have a health pot. Okay, actually, here's what we're gonna do. 1,000 Fists. Put back the 1,000 Fists. Then play this copy of it. Okay, yeah. So I didn't actually need to do that. This is enough damage. I could have put back basically any damaging card. But I don't think it matters one way or the other. Fight should be over now, and we should survive. Just put back whatever. This goes in. And yeah, she's already dead. Got both of the relics ready to go. And we're out of here. And you can see that the sheep we're doing, it's like, it doesn't even matter. Because the 1,000 Fists is always killing them for so much. Well, we will just take the Spirit Ward here. It's usually the one I go for. Probably not going to grab it anyway. The vision is so useful for us. Okay, Void Stones, huh? The Soul Sieve is actually kind of appealing as well. In fact, I actually think I'm just gonna buy this. This really improves my odds of being able to get a rare relic or a Queen Stone. And I would love a Queen Stone for this thing. Booster pack with a rare sounds pretty good too, though. Our defensive cards still kind of suck. We're still running a lot of the starter cards. Not that, you know, not that these are horrible, but they're certainly not outstanding. Also, just more vision, I think, would be cool. And I'll tell you what, a squid stance could be very good too. I could see this deck shifting dramatically towards ability chains, cutting all of these cards basically, and just purely relying on 1,000 Fists for damage. Void Stones, a blue stone would be very good. We could start making use of this. Black stones are always appreciated. I think I'm just gonna take the booster pack. See how this does me. I just want more cards. Okay. Mirror Guard's really nice. Everything else is kind of a whiff, though. We have literally no slow application, so we're gonna roll the rare, of course. Aggressive attack. Interesting. So this is my first source of vulnerable besides stillness. I'm not sure what to think about that. No queen. We get the Soul Collector, though. This is pretty good, too, though. There's a lot of relics that I wouldn't mind grabbing out of the Lost and Found. Counter, huh? That's interesting. Nothing really outstanding here, though. I mean, counter's pretty good. Steers us away from the ability chain direction that I was thinking we might want to go in. But, I mean, I guess if the floor rewards are a little underwhelming... Time Warp's worth a consideration. What kind of pathing can I do here? I can do something like this, right? I could do this. Time Warp could be pretty good. Yeah, I don't know, actually, it kind of seems really nice. This is a card that, yeah, I guess I didn't even mention this. The change on this one, I think, is really good. It used to be Future Strike triggers at the end of this turn. Now, it's Future Strike triggers at the end of this turn and the next turn. I was the one who really was pushing for this change because I really hated the fact that half of the time, Time Warp was literally just natural 20, right? If Future Strike was already triggering at the end of the turn, Time Warp was identical to natural 20. It has a bit more of an identity now in that it always gives you an extra turn where Future Strike triggers, and the upgrade for Purge Chain 1, of course, is still relevant. Anyway, so I guess this would be our path. Not the most exciting path in the world, but it hits everything that matters, and we get at least this one chest here. This upgrade is definitely going to be on Thousand Fists. This upgrade and this upgrade could go wherever, I guess. Nothing's like really screaming out to me. Reload, probably one of the upgrades. As for the other cards we got from the pack, let's talk about that briefly. Pinpoint is not going in. It's an expensive card. It doesn't really help me enter Zen that easily, especially in the early turns, and like any more so than a stability, that is, right? It's harder to go Zen with Pinpoint than stability. Obviously, Pinpoint is better in that you don't have to have it as an opener to get the double trigger of like a Void Stone or something, but we don't have a Void Stone for it. It deals a lot more Shi, but we don't care about the Shi that much. The damage is just all coming from Thousand Fists. Unload is, we're just past the point of this being relevant. We have nothing good to sift. Aggressive Attack would be good for Vulnerable, but I don't think it's gonna be good enough if we're using Time Warp instead. If I could upgrade it, maybe. It's just so expensive, though, you know? You don't really want big, expensive cards like that in Enlightened if you don't have Foresight, and we have literally no Foresight, I think, right? Not a single card with Foresight, somehow. Mirror Guard will go in, though. Expensive block card with the Aegis is nice. Getting double stacks of Echo Wall from that is nice. So I think we're just gonna leave it at this and see what this floor has in store for us. Still rocking with the health potion in the belt. Okay, I'm really glad if we're gonna fight our Chaos, it can be this early on. This dude's kinda spooky in the later floors when he has more health. Really sucks that this isn't upgraded right now, though. We're probably gonna hold this for block purposes, which means I don't really need this. Honestly, I think I'm just gonna put back the Reach Through Time and say we're not dealing with it right now. I'm gonna go Zen for the free card here. Just try and dig deeper to find this guy, the better future, to get my upgrade on the Thousand Fists. I mean, we do have 150% rage, courtesy of Red Pill, so it is actually dealing a pretty respectable amount of damage. In fact, if I just right now double dip on the Discipline, we actually get full block and 100% rage more to play this, instead of playing this twice. That seems better. We lose our Aegis charges, but we'll get them back. Zero energy going into a turn with Fumble 3 is always a little spooky, though, but I'm not feeling that bad with Delay Block. Okay, well, we're definitely holding this for that turn with 34. Put this on the bottom. Obviously, we don't need you. Go ahead and get Fatigued. Yeah, I think we just do it this way. Because next turn's not a Future Strike turn, so there's no way we can get a kill with if we grab back the Thousand Fists anyway. Yeah, we'll just pass like this. Alright, we can get enough Aegis charges here to double dip on the better future. Don't have any way of drawing cards, though. There's no way he dies. We'll just put one of these back. Yeah, we're taking a chunk here. It's not that massive, but it's a good bit. Oh, wait, I didn't double trigger it. Whoops. Okay, so far extra damage than was needed. It's fine. We're going to a shrine, right? We can heal at the shrine. And we have the health potion. I'm honestly not worried. I think we're fine. Definitely don't need you right now. You're just extremely dead now. As for which bead we want, could be honestly any of them, I think, right? Between the yellow, the red, the purple. We're getting another purple maybe, I guess, so we'll take the air bead. Definitely upgrading the Thousand Fists. Don't want to have to be messing around with Better Future just to make it worth playing. Oh, whoa, what the heck? I want all of these cards. They show up in the Lost and Found, so that's pretty sweet. I mean, last run, we did Circular Logic Thousand Fists. You guys saw how good that was. We'll try and do something a little different, I guess. Just for the sake of variety. In which case, yeah, two really good choices here. Path to Enlightenment is a very cool way to do the ability chain spam kind of thing, but now we're getting a counter. So it's like, do we really want to go down that path? It is still just a good card, and if you upgrade it, we draw two, discard two. Which is, I mean, that's so good with the Better Future. It's so good with Reach Through Time. It even lets us potentially play Quick Escape. Just get the free 12 blocks sometimes, right? Like, you vision it on top, you path to enlightenment. And it's a rare card, you know, it's cool, right? So, let's take the path. I'm not even sure we could afford to play a double run ragged. It's really expensive. So, upgrade you. Unfortunately, to get the time warp here, we do have to grab some empty nodes. Ouch. Okay, so if we're not really doing a lot of ability chaining, we're just going to combo this with a handful of other cards. I think that means that we just cut Repeating Deflection? I don't know. It is a block card as well. We want to make note of that. That means that we can go with Aegis and draw four, discard four, which is crazy. Also, this is probably where the purple stone is going, since it rebounds. But anyway. Yeah, when we get the counter, we're definitely going to want to have, like, all these stabilities for block. Until then, I'm not sure we want to cut the Repeating Deflection. We are taking little bits of chip damage here and there. I guess I could probably cut the Discipline. It's been forever since we've played it. And the green stone is here, finally. I honestly would rather put it on Run Ragged than Reach Through Time. Yeah. That's what we're gonna do. It's been a while since I've seen this background, because I've just had the interactive field on. This one's so good, dude. Okay, what the heck is happening this turn? A little annoyed that I've drawn the Thousand Fists here. Let's plan this out. We definitely are playing Run Ragged. Is there any way we go Zen? I don't know. We'd have to do double stability. Double stability. ability persists for 3. Purged Opposing Force, reach through time to play Run Ragged. You can purge the card we draw off the beads to play Thousand Fists. Oh, but wait, no, we're missing a card, yeah. This isn't our actual starting hand. We'll just put back the persist and let it be. Run Ragged. Guess we purge you. We have a lot of ways to get you back. And I actually don't think I want to reach through time. I'd rather Opposing Force you. Because we have the rage and stuff, so you take a bunch. And then you'll take another 16 on top of that. Yeah, very easy to kill him now. Tortoise buffing turn 1 is pretty... Oh my god, 40 damage! 40 damage, excuse me! Good thing we're killing you. Okay, double dipping this is already all of our block covered, so we'll just put back a repeating deflection. Drawing a card. Okay, let's grab the Thousand Fists then. We can go rage here. You're already gonna die. We'll go Zen. I guess we'll hit you. Thousand Fists is here, and it basically just kills everyone, actually, right? Because the she does it. Okay, good fight. that was a crazy turn they'd set up there. 40 damage. Okay. Ouch, down to 25. Interesting option here if we want to spend any souls. If we want to get a rare, we basically can't spend any. I guess I could always take some voids. What would we even dupe is the question, of course. The one of Thousand Fists, honestly, I think is fine. We have a lot of ways to get it back, and having a... It's really expensive to get a upgraded rare with a Blackstone. This would cost... Yeah, look at that. 3 voids or 11 souls. That is... I'm not willing to pay that much. Otherwise, this would be pretty crazy. 9 souls is very expensive, though. Just getting, like, an option that's pretty nice would just be something like this. Just for 1 void, we can get extra overcharge. That's, like, a very nice, cheap option. Run Ragged, I don't think makes sense. Because we're just not going to have enough energy for it, right? None of the cards we're getting here have, like, any cheeky ways to gain energy. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, the minimum, you're always getting 1 void minimum here. I really don't want to spend the souls because I really want a rare relic. So, am I okay with having the 1 of void... We'd have to fight 2 elites with it. Wouldn't get to purge until here. That means we also wouldn't get to heal. Maybe I just skip, honestly. Nothing that I'm willing to pay for would be, like, hugely impactful. It would just be a very minor upgrade that may well be offset by the voids. So I am going to pass, Mr. Mime. Not something I do often, but I think it's definitely right here. And that's a corkscrew. Seems pretty good, man. A lot of the times when I'm ending up with, like, multiple of these guys, corkscrew would be pretty good. Otherwise, don't really want the carrying case that much. It's okay, I guess. It lets us hold the Thousand Fists. These aren't the best elite artifacts I've ever seen. I don't know, maybe carrying case is best. It's probably the right choice. If we start to play a quick escape, it's pretty good to hold this with carrying case or to hold this. It's good to be able to hold the Thousand Fists, I guess, for Red Pill's turns. Yeah, okay. I'll just take the carrying case.
dang it, we drew Thousand Fists in the opening hand again. This is we drew this and this in the opening hand again. I don't want it. I want this on turn two. Okay, I'm just going to put back a repeating deflection, I guess. And we'll just do a nice little run ragged. The spell's not off cooldown yet, so I kind of want to hang on to this. I mean, I could just go Zen right now and play this for one. It'd be 84, which is a lot. Oh, wait. Oh, I forgot to put in the time warp. It's fine. We'll put it in after this. I should probably not waste the path to enlightenment. Next turn, it's triggering three times because of the Aegis, right? That's 15 block, which means that we just need repeating deflection or stability. And that gets us there, so... Or better future. Reload gets us into stuff, persist gets... Okay, yeah. You know what, we're not going to hold this. And we are going to hold both of these, I want to say. 42 is probably not worth it. Hey, Dan, what's going on, man? The run is going pretty well, I would say. We're a little low on health right now, but we got the health potion and we're coming up to a shrine. We have another Thousand Fists thing going on here. I got this rare we just picked up. This is one of the new ones. Pretty freaking cool. Draw two, upgrade both, discard two, and rebound. And we've got Aegis to double dip on it. It is a block card. And we've got... this as well, one of the new buffs. Getting vision, helping us get back the Thousand Fists. How are you doing, man? Okay, so we're fine in terms of block. We can just put this back. Because this is 15 block, this is 19. If we just trigger it once, which is what we want. We could better future some stuff back too to rig our draws, but we don't really have anything for it. This is a decent opposing force, but I'm gonna say no. Also to you. One red stability for rage is an option, I guess. Holding this for block, probably. So I guess we don't need the better future. All the stabilities. And says, I'll have to retry the exam in a month, but other than that, it's going fine. Ah, didn't go too well, man. That sucks. But, you know, we've all been there. I remember one time when I had an exam that was like a few days before the release of Street Fighter V. I'm a big fighting game fan. And I remember going to my exam and just absolutely bombing it. Like, I... 100% certain I failed, and I was like, all right, cool. And then I went to the game store that was like a 5-minute walk away, bought Street Fighter V, went home, and I was like, yep, yeah, whatever. You'll get him next time. Okay, so I think we don't actually need this. We're gonna go with repeating deflection. This puts us in Zen. I will take the rage. Can't use the spell, unfortunate. Beat you up pretty good here. And I feel fine about our block. Pretty good odds of getting the Aegis back up. And if we don't get it back up, we're drawing other defensive options, so... And this was your physics exam too, right, Dan? So it's like, honestly, you know, who even cares whether or not you know all this stuff about physics? You just need to get through the class and then you're never gonna use it again, I'm sure. Actually, because I forget if you actually told me exactly what your major was, but I'm pretty sure it didn't have anything to do with physics. let's just put a Daze back and we'll just draw it with Reload. Okay, the beads are ready, so the plan is gonna be, ideally we draw 1,000 Fists, or like Path to Enlightenment to get to 1,000 Fists, Persist helps us get there too, and then we play it and we use the spell and double dip. It was a little bit scary though. I think I will actually put back the Shield Wall for that reason. I am kind of scared. Dan says, yeah, hardest one of the last 3 or 4 years, not even close. Dang, dude. Is it just a general physics class, or is it something specific like fluid dynamics or some other nonsense? I heard those classes were very, very hard. I did not have to take them, luckily. But I've heard they're extremely challenging. Okay, we did get the 1,000 Fists. It's a Future Strike turn. Can we kill him? Can it be done? We don't really want to go Zen. Okay, I'm going to put back Mirror Guard. We're just going to take the easy option for Zen here. No visioning to be done before we draw. This is kind of rough, man. Yeah, he's definitely not dying to this. So I guess we're ditching that. Getting low on Zen card plays. But we're just enough block now. And I will hold this to get back 1,000 Fists, right? Or do I need to get block? I don't know. We're holding it anyway, carrying case. This guy's a threat, man. Okay. Yeah, it's way too late for you reach two times. Sorry. And we're not actually able to draw here. We can't even get the Aegis up, frustratingly. We're close, but we can't quite do it. We will get some pretty good Echo Wall damage here, though. Jeez, man. I guess we'll put back these two, since the Aegis will be live, and we're probably just going to be chugging our health potion here. General physics includes mechanics, thermodynamics, electromagnetism. At least the questions were on electromagnetism, which is just painful to study. I very vaguely remember some of the electromagnetism stuff. Definitely remember that it was not fun. Look how close that is, man. Does the rage actually get us there? That's 12 plus 2. And it's going to be rounded up. That's 18 plus, so that's 21, right? And he's got 88, so that would put him up to 109. So that would actually be enough, I think, right? Yeah, there we go. Dan says, at least I'm pretty sure I'll never use any of it again after university. Yep, that is so often the case with these kinds of classes, isn't it? Okay. So I guess we could have spent a handful of souls. We got low rolls on the costs here. I still feel like this was the right choice, though. These can cost like 20, 21, so. Half of our excess block becoming delay block is actually kind of good, because we do have some turns where we get a bunch of excess block, or we just like trigger an Aegis when we didn't really want to. So that's pretty nice. Also, just a defensive relic in general, I think, is good, because we're just kind of waiting for, like, fatigue to build up, and then the Thousand Fists slaps people down. So I don't mind this at all. I think I'll just grab it. And let that be that. So now we're getting the counter. Which I honestly don't even know if we're going to use the counter, truthfully. Also, I do think it's probably a good idea to do this swap. Since we can discard it with Path to Enlightenment. And we definitely want the Time Warp in, we said. We'll cut this stability for Time Warp. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if we're going to keep in enough stabilities for the counter to make sense. It's just kind of not really what we're doing. We're playing, like, one really crazy huge attack, not a bunch of small ones. This fight's pretty easy most of the time for us, though. Just gotta remember not to use the carrying case. Because these guys are strong when you have cards in hand. Counter could also synergize well with the cloak depending on the rounding. Oh, that's true, actually. I wasn't thinking about the fact that it works with cloak. I mean, it's probably worth putting in. We don't have a greenstone for it, so, like, it might just get purged a lot. And we have nothing that helps us generate energy, somehow. But there's still one more elite to fight, so, you know, maybe we get Pickled Hand. What are we even doing this turn? Probably just Path to Enlightenment stuff. Let's get rid of you. Time Warp, Thousand Fist is coming up. We're not playing the Reach Through Time very often. Show me Thousand Fists! There it is. And we had the beads, of course. If all else failed. So we'll go Zen. Give him the Daka Daka Daka. Honestly, I mean, I guess, right? No real reason not to. When will this patch come out on the normal client? I actually do not know if there's a set date for that yet. Because there's... What's going on right now is that the Enlightened buff is out, right? That patch I'm pretty sure is out on the main client. Yeah, that came out 3 days ago. But there's still, like, stuff being tweaked with the... all the resolution changes and some other visual things. Lots of little visual things. So, yeah, I mean, I don't know when the next one is going to be, given that. If you just want to play with all these cards and stuff, that's already out. There's Thousand Fists. 216 damage. Why can't you be dying? There we go. Oh, okay, yeah, so you didn't know that the this one was out. Yeah, it just came out a couple days ago. I mean, you've been busy with school stuff, right? It's probably good that you're focusing on exams rather than video games. Okay, this upgrade is just, like, does not matter, really. This upgrade's okay, don't think we have anything. I mean, counter. I'm pretty sure, given the way that the cloak works, and if you block for two, you have one excess block, but if you block for three, you have one and a half, which I think rounds up to two. You're gaining two delay block, I think. Usually it rounds up. Hey, Squeak, what's going on? Yeah, man, it's so much slower to do runs when you're talking and stuff, but not that I mind. Run is going pretty well. We've got another 1,000 fists going. I specifically avoided circular logic because we just did that run, but I might grab it anyway at the lost and found here. We'll see. Yeah, let's try the counter out. We have low health, but I'm not really all that worried. We have a health pot, we have a shrine we're about to visit with the voids in deck. And we're going to be doing Echo Cloak counter right now. Honestly, dude, it feels bad, but I feel like I'm going to take out Reach Through Time. Like, I upgraded this card, and it's a new card, but we just are not playing it. It's just a little too slow for what we're doing. We need faster revision. Or just deck cycling. Yeah, I think on average a streamed run I do for high difficulty takes like 2 hours-ish. Unless I get something like really crazy or I'm playing Tempest. okay, well, we got both of these. We can hold one with the carrying case, I guess. Get rid of you, play you. I mean, I kind of want to hold this with the carrying case. I can hold both. This thing is already charged up, so it's a full block anyway. Go away, persist. Are we going Zen here? We play two of these. This guy costs two. We have to purge this one. I don't think it makes sense. I'll do it this way. We'll keep the 1,000 fists with our carrying case, and pretty good odds that we just go Zen with, like, attacks. Pop off with this thing. We took the red pills kind of thinking it might not be great, and it hasn't been great. We've been struggling to trigger it, but it's big on the turns where we do trigger it, and it'll definitely help against the void. Okay, we don't need two of you. We have reload, discarding, quick escape. That's very handy. You're dying. It is not a future strike turn. Time warp is in the deck. Huh. You know, I think it's actually better to do the reload here and try to draw time warp. Better future is a good draw as well. Oh, we drew the time warp. Okay, that's big. So we're going to discard you and you. Play the time warp for the Vuln. Play this to go Zen and get block. Then we'll just kill you off. You kill yourself. Now! and then the Exalted Warrior is the only one left. Feels pretty good. This is like a terrible hand to be blocking with. But this damage number actually isn't real. It's only the 14, which means that... Oh yeah, and counter's down now, so we're fine. We're totally fine. I will actually put a daze back. Okay, so let's watch... Or wait, are we going to be able to see? Yeah, we'll be able to see. So currently we have 3 delay block. This gives us 3 block when we play an attack. And this gives us half of the excess block as delay block. So I think it's going to round 1.5 up to 2. When I play this, I should have 5 delay block. I do have 5 delay block. Okay, it worked. One sec, I got to go let my dog out. Be right back. Okay. Yeah, so it seems like we're going to be generating actually a pretty huge amount of delay block with this counter then. Let's see. Squeak says, I don't know why, but I don't really like the Mindful spec. I've had way too many shit floor one solo fights. And Marshall got some good buffs too. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I've always liked Mindfulness quite a bit more because of how good it is at hallway fights. Whereas Marshall is kind of slow to get off the ground. But it is, you're right to point out that it's worse against single target fights, in particular the elites on floor one, right? Are generally single target fights. Even Bruce, who spawns the fish, right? You just want to fight Bruce and kill him. You don't care about the fish. But the biggest difference between the two of them, I would say, is just that Marshall tends to be a lot stronger against the Void. You need to find a handful of specific things to be answers. We luckily have two of those. We have the Escalate, as well as Thousand Fists. So, but I think they're probably pretty close. I think Mindfulness was definitely the better starting deck before the buffs. Now I feel like they're probably pretty close. Most of the starting decks, I think, are pretty close at this point. Daughter is probably still the biggest difference. Corruption Daughter being significantly worse. But not bad, just worse. Dan says, the Future Strike didn't turn green under the mob, probably a bug. Yeah, I guess that's just a visual thing, that Time Warp doesn't change the Future Strike damage. Should mention that in the Discord. And Squeak says, Mindfulness can get into Zen easily and is better in AoE fights, but a bit mad getting into Zen through Red Chains sometimes. Yeah, stability is really, like, the reason that the Mindfulness deck is so strong. It's just such a crazy card. We want both of these back. Stability is just so good. It's such a strong target for Void Stones. It's such an easy way to go Zen. Condensing the number of cards you need to go Zen really helps, especially if you're starting with Voids or if you get garbage put in your deck. Okay, this is a little bit weird, but this is what we need to do here. And yeah, we'll do that. Dan says, if I'm trying to get a run going, I usually reroll until I get Escalate either in the booster or on floor one. It is really hard to kill the Void without either getting some crazy Future Strike or exactly having Escalate. There are ways it can be done, though. One thing that's new, Dan, give this a try, Squid Stance. I was hoping we'd get a good run with Squid Stance going, but we have not seen one. Squid Stance can stack like crazy in long fights like the Void. I had a run earlier where I had over 400 delay block just from Squid Stance, which was really good. Really good against the Void. These cost 900, right? No, they cost more than that. We cannot afford one of these. That kind of sucks. Cultist Ward would have been pretty good. But there's really good cards here. As for which one I actually want, I'm not sure. This did get changed to Future Strike. I kind of feel like it could have stayed at raw damage. This is decent, puts us further down the attack spam option that Counter has kind of encouraged. Don't care about Clairvoyance, it's too expensive. Second Run Ragged is potentially very cool, but it's also very expensive with no Foresight. Circular Logic is probably just the objectively correct choice. I am kind of trying to vary my runs up, but you know, I mean, this is I-50, right? It's hard. It's very hard. I should probably just take the Circular Logic. Try and get a win here. I like winning. Winning's fun. We'll cut a repeating deflection for Circular Logic, because we can do that now, and I think it's actually to the point where we want to cut repeating deflection for stability as well. Just to go goes in with attacks more and just use counter, but counter's not rigged, so I don't want to get rid of all of my regular block cards. So I think we're just going to leave it at this. Dan says, I did a Void once with only Echo Wall, Reverb, and some basic attacks. Yeah, Reverb is another crazy one that can definitely close out the fight against the Void. Centipede Stance is an unironic win condition, especially if you Blackstone it. Yeah, Centipede Stance and Squid Stance both can just straight up win you fights, but in order to do it, you need a lot of vision, and currently I think just visioning the Thousand Fist is not only more important, but probably better. If I could have bought the Cultist Ward, then, you know, there might have been more of an argument for it, but I think the Thousand Fists will take care of us just fine. Pretty good options here between these two. Band of Resilience is pretty funny as well with Aegis, triple triggers. I think I just want the pouch. Oh, Dolus! I hate fighting Dolus so much, dude. Oh, God. So now that I play with Blind Spot on most of the time, she's just so frustrating. Hey, at least we get a cheap Run Ragged, though, right? That's cool. Woo! Don't really want to play this. I can hang on to this. Nothing worth doing with better futures. Nothing to do with my energy on this turn. Pretty bad hand. I could do this just so she's Vuln next turn, I guess. It's something. I'm gonna purge this and hold this. We have a number of ways to discard this thing. Also, am I crazy? Why is this the next five turns? What just happened? Why did five turns? What just happened? Card triggered, time warp. I only played it once. I don't know what just happened. Is this like some weird bug with Dolus? It costed one though, right? What the heck? If anyone has any idea what just happened, fill me in. It applied only to Vuln, yeah, which is, it's supposed to do that, right? It's just, for some reason, it, five? How do you get five? That's not even a multiple of two. What? Very confused. Okay, so I think what we're doing here is stability, counter, purge this one, path to enlightenment, discard that, and that. Discard this thing, get the mirror guard down, that'll make her take a lot. I think this is where we're at. Just waiting for Thousand Fists, Thousand Fist waiting room. That's why I'm keeping path. Just in case we don't draw it, I want to guarantee that we have it. And then we can double dip with the vision. Because we can go Zen with abilities here, right? But we don't want to. We want to do it this way. Oh, thank God. That's really nice that it's free. Now we're Zen. Do this. Get it back. Honestly, it might be more important just to get the time warp. Truthfully, just for the Vuln. Because it's cheaper as well. Well, actually, no, it's not cheaper. It's Dolus. We have no idea if it's cheaper. Definitely gonna do this. Oh, wait. I miscounted. Fine, I'll take one. Alright, I gotta go let the dog back in. One sec. 4 minus 3 is pretty hard math. Yeah, it's true, dude. It's true. Dan's over here trying to do his physics exam on electrodynamics, and I'm over here like, what's 4 minus 3? Alright, we're confused. Everything's really expensive. Probably not going Zen. So I think what I'm gonna do here is literally just set up Echo Wall. Purge down, like, all of this stuff. And just try and get her with this. The beads are ready to go. Next turn is somehow still a Future Strike turn. So I guess this works. Got the Time Warp as well for Vuln application. So try to go Zen like this. That's pretty effective. Nice and cheap stuff. Rage. I don't think we need the Rage. I'm pretty sure she's just gonna die from the regular Thousand Fists. Yeah, she's very dead. Get our heal here, I guess. I could take the money, try and get better stuff from the Well of Stars. Probably better not to be greedy. You know, just in case. Just in case I forget what 4 minus 3 is. Purple Stone. We want stabilities again really badly at this point, so seems fine to me. Hey, finally a fight where I don't need to feel so bad about not triggering red pills ever. Okay. Path, Time Warp, Run Ragged. Seems good. Let's get rid of you then. Oh, whoops. Double triggered off the Aegis. That is not what I was intending to do. And that's all our vision as well, so we'll just get it back like this. I guess we'll toss this stability to the bottom. We want the counter, but we're gonna be fine in terms of block on this turn anyway. Probably no opposing force, and I guess no reload. This is basically reload anyway. Beat you up, grab this back, foresee it, do this. Ditch these. I can play it twice. Blocking is a concern. Probably should not. Probably purge it, huh? Should probably purge it. It's a juicy 66, but yeah, I should purge it. Oh, wait a minute. Time Warp is like, what? It wasn't doing that before, was it? Was it always doing that? I mean, if I play it on turn one, it's like, is it just counting? No, I don't know. I don't know what it's doing. I cannot think of why it is behaving that way. Okay, each stability blocks for 3. Path is still better. So it's just counter,
Persist. Path. Path.
Oh, that was good. That was a nice draw.
Glad I prayed for healing at that shrine. The first time used it, it didn't say I feel like that too. I'm gonna have to go check the VODs and see. It's very strange behavior on this card. Okay, got a big old shield wall this turn. We can probably get Aegis going too. Counter is finally in play. So let's put back Better Future. For good measure, we'll even do Yellowstone Stability twice. Puts us into Zen. Punch you. Couple of abilities. This thing's gonna be ready to go. I will just put back the shield wall. Yeah, I'm gonna have to mess around with the time warp and see what the heck's going on with it. Anyway, this fight is really getting out of control, dude. This guy's at 8x6. Better Future is the last card. That really sucks. That sucks a lot. I wanted to do Better Future for Quick Escape and then reload to discard the Quick Escape. I guess I could still do that if I persist. Yeah, I guess that works. We put this back on the bottom. Get our ghosted card, draw a copy. This is going to double trigger the Better Future, which is actually not what we want. So we'll play this. Then we Better Future, putting back these two in that order, and then we ditch this and that, and we have you with Carrying Case. You're not attacking next turn. Okay. Think we're in the clear now. So I can block this, no problem. Get rid of this crap. Stop the haunting like this. For a little bit more, I guess. He's always vulnerable. I don't want to do this. We need to kill you, obviously. Echo Wall kills you. So I don't think we need the Time Warp here, actually, at all. Because you're going to die like that. You're going to die like that. You die to Echo Wall. Look at all that chi as well. Take 70 damage, my friend. Alright, Tower Shield is definitely not going in the deck. I have no idea who we're fighting here, of course. Am I going to use a potion? No. Why would I do that? What do you take me for? Okay, Blood Hive. This guy's not that tough. No taunt guy is nice. It's really annoying with Future Strike, although with Time Warp, it does sort of alleviate that issue a bit. We don't really need the opposing force right now. I want to double trigger the overcharge here. I mean, I guess I might as well do this if it lasts for a million turns, right? But now it's only two! What is going on? I'm lost. I'm very confused. Whatever, man.
I feel like even after the changes, Bloodhive is still the nicest floor 2 boss by quite a bit. Nicest, I guess you mean the nicest one to, like, roll, the least dangerous. I agree. He is generally not that hard. Okay, we've got Reload Quick Escape, so that's pretty cool. Let's just stick you on the bottom. Path to Enlightenment as well now. Play it once. Pitch this and that. There's the counter. Circular on the Thousand Fists that we just got rid of. Now we're in Zen. Throw this down. And next turn we're looking funky fresh. Okay. Most of the setup is done at this point, I would say. We've still got you two together. Beads are not yet ready, though. He's gonna die. Okay, so we don't really need this at all. We do want this. Loop that guy back. Beads are ready, so I'm not gonna worry about using the spell on this turn. You can use it on next turn. 176 Future Strike is a lot. Time Warp could definitely get us into a situation where we're just wrapping things up. In fact, yeah, I'm gonna be real greedy about this. Put the days back. See if I care. I will take block from the stability, though. Oh, great. Wait, I thought that was supposed to go to the bottom. What? And another days that I forgot about? I don't know what's going on. Whatever. Okay, better future. That'll get us back. It's only a single trigger. That'll get us back the Thousand Fists, and I guess we want the stability for Rage. That. And Path to Enlightenment potentially being drawn for Quick Escape. Yeah, why not? We'll hold it with the carrying case. Oh, wait. The daze still goes to the top even if you card sharp it? Is that what you're saying? Didn't I do that exact play earlier and it didn't go on top? Or is it just that when a date? I could have sworn I put a dazed on the bottom of my deck earlier and it actually went to the bottom. Maybe not. I don't know. It's probably like an ordering thing where like the card type sleeve says, okay, put this at the bottom of the deck, and then the daze says, oh, when I go into the deck, I go on top. That's my guess. All right, we got Time Warp. Yeah, Reload and Path to Enlightenment. I guess we will ditch this guy then. Start with Path, dropping that and that, and that again, I guess, why not, right? Then we can Time Warp for the correct amount. So weird. You've already rebounded, let's just play the free one. No. Yeah, okay, we're good. Get some Rage, clobber you. Nice knowing ya. Try to exit Zen here to... Nah, there's no possible way to get back into Zen for B triggers. Okie doke. Probably not going to use Swarm, even though it is one of the better spells. Yeah, that's one thing that's interesting. Bloodhive is probably the easiest floor 2 boss. I feel like his spell is one of the best. Pretty interesting. Booster pack with a rare, probably not. I'm pretty happy with where the deck is at here. I don't think there's much that I really would be looking for. 25 max is okay. Void Stones would be really good. Void Stones would be really good, actually. A green for counter, or even a black. Blues for the quick escape, anything to go into stability. Give me stones. Okay, green and black. We'll get the yellow because why not? Bloodhive spell is probably the best spell in the game. Really? I would definitely disagree with that. It is very good, but best in the game? That's hard to say. Like, for example, with this deck, it's a plus one trigger, right? Thousand Fist is already a card that gets a lot of its value off the fact that it's a double trigger. So, you're not actually getting as much value as you'd hope when you double trigger this card. Also, you know, of course, it's got the inert, right? So you aren't getting extra value out of the Void Stones. The fact that the starting spells often, you know, synergize more so with what the cards are likely to have do. But there's definitely, like, crazy high rolls. Like, if you have, a bleed trigger card that's not in Cold Blood, you can use that. Like, bleed it out, right? You can bleed it out with Swarm, and that's really crazy. There's stuff that's really crazy. I would say the best spell is Sacrifice Daughters. That one's really, really good, too. I mean, just for the super cheap... I'm thinking of the other one. The Sacrifice Daughter one that gives you Death Strike. Yeah, that one's really, really good. The other one for Daughter, though, that lets you sift is super good, too, just because it has a two-turn cooldown. Being able to use your spell every other turn is crazy, and it goes nuts with all the spell synergy relics. There's a lot of good spells out there, man. It's hard to make a case for any one being just the best. Very situational. I will say the Spell Child spells do feel kind of underwhelming most of the time, though. Anyway, right, let's make some choices here, huh? We're having a little bit of issues blocking. Counter would help with that a lot. But do I want to just see it faster, or do I want to get, like, maximum value? If I put a Greenstone in it, I've got 2 3-cost cards in my opening hand. Let me check what blessings I could get, though. Stealth and full energy. Ooh, okay. If I take stealth plus full energy and also first 2 cards trigger twice, I can double counter and double run ragged, and that seems crazy. I don't think I need a triple counter, right? So that means that I could put the green stone in counter itself. I have stealth, I have full energy, I can easily play both of them and not worry about the rest of the turn. Which frees up the black stone for... Honestly, I don't know what, there's a lot of choices. Probably persist, actually. I really like persist just as a highly flexible way to draw. You can vision something, then draw that thing, then play that thing, then draw another card, right? Like, I can use my spell to put back Better Future, or draw the Better Future with the first copy of Persist, play the Better Future, draw the next card. It's really flexible, really powerful. It kind of becomes like a pseudo-stability, too, in that it's just an easy way to go Zen. So I'm going to do that, and I'm going to do this. And the Yellowstone will just go on another stability, and I will feel a lot better fighting Death Knight with counter in my opening hand, even if I have to pass on the run ragged initially. What cards do I want to cut here? I feel like it's fine to leave in Path to Enlightenment, because where is that card? There it is. Even though it's a block card, right, it draws and discards, so, like, it'll generate Banes, but I can get rid of the Banes, and I might need this thing. Definitely gonna cut Repeating Deflection, just for stability. Quick Escape, we don't actually have to play, so that one's safe. And... Shield Wall, Mirror Guard are just, like, really chunky blocks, so if I'm desperate, they'll kick the can down the road in terms of the problems I'm dealing with. Block now for Banes later is probably okay if I have to play one of these. I think this is a good deck. How do we want to use these? I don't need to save the Stealth Potion for the Void, because I'm going to have Stealth for free. So I probably use it against the Thanos dude. Obsidian Golem, that guy. Which means that against this dude, I could use the Iron Skin Potion? Because versus Void, I want to brew... actually, geez, what am I gonna do here? Versus Void, I probably want Patience Potion in the belt. I guess the brew could just be Iron Skin, I don't know, which means that I don't use a potion against this guy. That's fine, I think I'm pretty strong against him with this setup, with counter. Counter's very good against Death Knight, you know, go figure. Bottom of the deck, Path. I forgot that this was a card back. Not my favorite card back, gotta say. Okay, so we have a lot of block generation here. Can I afford to play this Time Warp? It's a pretty big deal. You know, screw it. Screw it. We're going in. How do we want to do this now? Definitely playing this. Definitely purging this. His favorite card back, probably Mistletoe Treasure Goblin. That's a good one, yeah. I like the one that you get for perfecting the Star Council, where it's like the tentacle wrapping around the globe. That one's really cool. Okay, yeah, so we need more block, which means that I should put back with my spell something for the persist. There is actually nothing great to put back. I could put back the reload, actually, and there's decent odds of getting quick escape. Let's do that. Hey! What can I say? Sometimes it just works out. Yeah, I'm not really a fan of the whole anime girl aesthetic thing. Circular logic is pretty good here. I guess we can put back... Path's our only draw. Okay, let's put back Better Future then. Block, block. This is gonna draw us a card. Give me this. He's still Vuln, of course. So, this is fine. Give me the Banes, I don't care. Don't need you. Not really the time for you right now, sorry, dude. And we're just gonna keep going. Keep the Thousand Fists coming. He's not Vuln anymore. Go away, Bane. We might draw into the Thousand Fists here. Now we got a couple options, so I will go with Stability first here. Definitely gonna put this back on him. I think I'm gonna hold Reload plus Quick Escape. We'll just get Delay Block. I should have some energy. Best one is Jorb's Dig. I don't really watch Jorb's like at all. So I don't really have much to say on... I know that the Dig thing is like a meme. Oh, which... That is not what I wanted to do. For some reason, I thought I was discarding already. Yeah, Jorb's stream was just not quite my pace. I used to watch Baylor Lord all the time on Slay the Spire. I watched, like, hundreds of hours of that stream. But I'm kind of done with Spire at this point. I have, like, 700 hours in it or something ridiculous. Probably not that much. That's an exaggeration. In fact, I can just check on my Steam right now. No, I have 476 hours You know, it's a handful. Okay, I don't think we're ever killing him here, right? Guess I'm playing opposing force. Is he dead here? I think he's dead here. There goes my Aegis, though. That's fine. Get out of here! Deck pack's pretty cute, just the wizard with some elements. Yeah, it's alright. I have it unlocked, but, I don't know, I guess I like the stuff that has, like, more of a cool aesthetic rather than a cute aesthetic. That's more my style. I don't know, I like weird stuff, as evidenced by my little starting screen. I made this image. Dan says, I barely have 10 hours in Spire and only because of meme mods. Yeah, I mean, it's like the OG, right? So if you played it back in the day, you know, you probably played a lot of it because there wasn't really anything that was like it. Nowadays, there's a lot of other deck builders, so... Okie doke. Here we get to use the stealth potion for free because this thing gives us stealth against the void. Not having control over what cards I put. I hate not having control over what cards I put in my deck in deck builders. Yeah, so it's definitely like a skillful thing, but you know, it's not always about whether or not something's skillful or not. Sometimes you just don't enjoy a certain mechanic. I definitely understand that. I personally don't mind having to be forced to put cards in. But it is definitely a very, I guess, liberating experience to then play a game like this. And it's like, dude, I'm just going to have the best 20 cards that I've seen and no more. I'm just going to play everything here. Yeah, I played... In-person deck builders like Star Realms and that other one that's really popular that I can't remember. Ascension, is it called? Yeah, and so in those, you get to freely choose what goes into your deck, but it's like if you don't add more cards, you're just going to lose. So your hand is kind of forced. I want a circular, and I want a time warp. I guess I don't need both of these, really. So let's do better future, I guess, for these two, just so I can go Zen with abilities, and then we'll go circular on you, and we'll draw you, and it's already so much damage. Jeez, dude. We have to purge this to play the other copy. I'm just going to go ahead and do this. Try and make sure I don't die next turn and get more rage. We have 5 turns of time warp again, mysteriously. Yeah, I will say one thing that this game excels at is, like, really... mitigating the number of things that are just completely outside of player control, right? Like, the fact that you can always retain cards, the fact that you can always choose how much energy you have access to versus how many cards you play, the fact that you can see exactly which cards are where on the map and how to get them. You know, you see the Void Stones ahead of time, you see the Vault Guardians and their blessings ahead of time. There is, like, so much control given to the player. Very infrequently do I lose a run, or even just take a big hit in a fight in this game and think, ah, you know, bad luck. It happens, right? You know, anytime you're drawing random cards from a deck, there are draws that are better than others. But it happens a lot less often than with, like, Spire, you know, which I think is reflected in the design as well. Spire expects you to take hits semi-frequently, and it's about managing, you know, how much damage you're willing to take in a fight. In this game, you could realistically perfect almost every fight, at least, you know, past a certain point on instability. I don't know about 50, but, like, even up to 30, you could probably perfect every single fight if you played really, really well. And that's why there's only a handful of healing points, whereas Inspire, they give you bonfires all the time. Yeah, it's pretty interesting, man. It's pretty interesting. I love this game, but I don't think that's a surprise to y'all. Let's just get rid of the stability, I guess. Get you back. Get you cheap. Reload. We don't need you again. Path. It's not quite gonna kill, yeah. Because, let's do the math here. 88 plus another 88 is 176. Yeah, that's not gonna kill at all. It just looks like it because it doesn't account for, like, the fortitude. So, fine. We'll be boring. We'll block. Because I think I've only taken a shrine heal like twice ever. What difficulty do you normally play on Squeak? You play at least on impossible, right? I don't remember exactly. On below I-30, yeah, you can basically just like always pray for greed or cleansing. On I-50, I pray for healing somewhat often, maybe half of the time. But, I mean, it'd be insane to talk about playing max difficulty Spire and only healing half of the time. Like, nobody would probably be able to manage that. Dan says, from the few runs I did, there are so many fights that just kill a run because you don't have the right deck and you can't do anything about it. Yeah, so you have to... When you're drafting cards in Spire, you have to have very specific ideas in mind. Like, you have to say, when you're starting a run, especially a high difficulty run, and you're on the first floor... The first handful of cards you pick up, almost like, I want to say, 90% of the decision-making process is how does this affect my Gremlin Knob matchup? Because you have to fight elites early to get the relics, obviously. And if you fight Gremlin Knob and you don't have a deck that matches up against him really well, you will die. Like, very consistently he's going to kill you if you're not specifically drafting against him. And there's only a 1 in 3 chance that your first elite is even a Knob anyway, right? And I personally don't mind having to play that way. I think it's kind of fun and it rewards your knowledge of the fights a lot, but it's a very different way of playing versus, like, in this game, you're more specifically thinking about what are the synergies I can generate between the cards I have access to, the relics I have, how do I mitigate, you know, general concepts like solo fight versus AoE fight, right? How do I manage a fight where I need to kill two enemies at the same time versus a fight where I just need to turbo down one enemy or something like that? Very different thought process that go into which cards you put in your deck in the two games. Squeak says, I play I-30 with coins and I-50, but I get a small aneurysm when I think of all the value I'm missing. Really, though, you play I-50 frequently and you've only healed, like, twice ever. I find that a little surprising. I heal somewhat often, like I said. Not super often, but somewhat often. Okay, no vision, so we don't really need to go for rage here. Generate lots of block. Get the Echo Wall, why not? We will actually need to play Mirror Wall for a full block here. It's a bit annoying, but whatever, I guess. Usually I also have some Voids to destroy, and 500 Essence isn't that good or anything, but it's something. It is something, it's true. I guess that's more so... I tend to be someone who plays for consistency, and I think healing at I-50 is oftentimes the more consistent play versus praying for essence, where it's like, you might miss that essence, but the healing guarantees your run goes further more often. Obviously, the getting voids out of the deck is like, you have to do that first, you know, if you're starting with voids. I always take less HP, instability, blood libraries, etc. So 30% of a HP bar seems like not too much. Yeah, I usually like to do that as well, although as of late with the various modifiers that have been added in, I'm finding it nicer to lower your starting health, but still have the healing to higher amounts at the end of each floor. Like here, I only have one stack of Festering Scars on, so I heal for 75% of my missing health. And that encourages me to heal less, too. It used to be that I would take, like, max Festering Scars, and then you're hardly getting any health at all between floors, which makes praying at shrines better. Yeah, I guess how much you pray really depends somewhat heavily on your instability setup when you're on this difficulty. And as more and more modifiers get added, it's going to become... There's going to be, like, a greater degree of variation. So... Anyway, I think it's about time that we finish this guy off, huh? I got really sidetracked talking about Spire and stuff. Let's go fight the Void, huh? Okie doke. Release our souls. An even, clean 1500. Oh, wait. Whoops. I forgot. We have one stack of Praetorian Guard. We gotta fight this jerk, too. Should be fine. We have quite a bit of draw and discard. Just put back you, I guess. I don't know. What I-30 coin took you the longest slash you found the hardest? I haven't cleared all the coins yet. Out of the ones I've done... You know what? I don't actually remember all of the ones that I've done. I'll have to take a peek after this run. The one about perfection is kind of tough. The one with the Tempest where... What was the one with the Tempest? There was one with the Tempest that was really annoying, where you were, like, putting... I think you had the card Sharp Sleeve, and there was some weird effect. It wasn't that hard, but it was kind of annoying to manage. I'll check after this run. Definitely don't remember off the top of my head. Okay, let's see. Don't really have a lot of ways to block here, but we can get Aegis and at least get, like, 12 out of this, for what that's worth. Pretty low on energy here, though. Kind of sucks. This is a full block. Hold the Thousand Fists. Don't really care because of this. You know, I mentioned Baylor. I will say that's one thing I really liked about his Spire streams that I try to do. Whenever I'm, like, talking about something or making a play that might not seem obvious, he would always, when he did that kind of stuff, he would always mouse over the thing that was, like, relevant. I really like that. I try to do that too, because I think for viewers it kind of helps you understand the thought process. Yeah, Baylor's streams were great, man. He played this game at least once, a little while ago though. I remember him saying like, yeah, you know, it's cool, but it needs some more time in the oven. So maybe when the game comes out, he'll stream some more. I'll definitely watch that. Okay, I totally could have gone for Rage here, yeah. Let's just do Thousand Fists, Time Warp, get back the real Thousand Fists, Persist into the Thousand Fists. Yeah, this is the kind of stuff I was talking about with the Blackstone Persist. So crazy. 136 damage. Up to 6 stacks of Time Warp. Noxious introduced me to the game. Yeah, I remember Noxious streamed some of this. I used to know him back from when he was, like, involved in Hearthstone, right? He was a Hearthstone guy, wasn't he? I'm not thinking of someone else with a very similar name. I'm pretty sure he did, like, commentary or something for Hearthstone tournaments. Yeah, I remember I saw him play. He hasn't played it in a while, though, I think. I went to go check his VOD page, and he's been playing some other stuff. The Tempest one that you get burned was Zeal. That one was really easy, Squeak. It wasn't that one. The other one is that you get the debuff where your cards become volatile. Right, that was the annoying one, the volatile card one. We're definitely playing this. So I guess we'll just do this first. Grab that and make it free. Then we'll reload. He's still Vuln, so we don't really need to time warp. Wait a minute, is he about to steal my Thousand Fists? Am I stupid? Put the Banes back and then drew the Banes. I think I just screwed up. He played and casted Hearthstone. Yeah, that sounds right. Magic the Gathering too, huh? Interesting. Magic, it's so weird to me. Magic is something that I just have never really had interested in. Like, I like every major card game, practically. Like, video games and, I like all the deck builder games and stuff, right? Yeah, okay, that was stupid. There goes my Thousand Fists. I'm really into Yu-Gi-Oh! I collected a lot of Pokemon cards as a kid, although I guess I didn't play it much. Played, like, you know, a ton of Spire, played a bunch of, like, in-person deck builder games. Magic just never really did it for me. I don't know. I think what I dislike the most about Magic is the, inability to... The player who's aggressive with attacks is, like, totally out of control. Because the other person gets to declare blockers, right? Whereas, like, in Yu-Gi-Oh! You just attack, and every creature has to be killed before you hit face, or, like, in, even, like, I've been playing a little bit of Legends of Runeterra, even, right? Recently, and in that game, it's like, you declare your attacks, and they declare blocks, but, I feel like in that one, it's not as bad, because you can block with multiple creatures in Magic, can't you? Or am I misremembering that? Either way, I don't have anything against Magic. It's like, you know, the reason that card games exist as they are now. It just wasn't for me. I also don't like how the mana system is random. You know, just the fact that you might not get mana to curve out is pretty annoying. It's not a great look we've got there. I did play some Cube, though, for Magic with one of my friends whose family actually owned a card shop, and that was pretty fun. I did enjoy drafting. Magic Gathering Limited is the best way to play a card game. Which format specifically is Limited? Or do you just mean in general Limited? Magic has like a million formats with different names, and I don't know most of them. If you just mean in general, playing without access to most of the cards, then I would agree. I think limited formats tend to be more fun. That's like the only way I play Yu-Gi-Oh! For the most part nowadays is play Cube or, other ridiculous formats. Planar action mid-turn is cool. Feels a bit over the top when you can just stop anything for like 3 mana. It's done a bit better in Runeterra. Do you mean in Magic, being able to counterspell stuff? Yeah, it's kind of crazy. I mean, if you want to talk about annoyingly having all your stuff countered, Yu-Gi-Oh! Is absolutely the worst in that regard. So much negation, so much disruption. It's not very fun. But in a limited environment, Yu-Gi-Oh! Can be a blast. Let's just keep the Vuln up, why not? We're up to 9 stacks. Limited is usually mono expansion drafting. How do the drafts usually go? Is it like you have like 5 cards and you take one and then pass like that? That's what I'm used to. You have like five cards in a pack, your opponent has 5 cards, you take one that you want, they take one that they want, and then you guys trade. You go back and forth until all those cards are gone, and then you get new cards. Keep doing that until you have a deck of whatever size you decided. 8 players with 3 packs each. I would like to do more drafts with lots of people, but I only have so many friends in real life who play card games, so I usually can't do more than 2 people or 3 people for a draft, unfortunately. Okie doke. We said we were going to... I guess Iron Skin. I was supposed to drink this at the end of that fight, but it's probably not going to matter. Let's get into it. Okay, so this turn we have Stealth. Persist is actually going to draw us cards. We might as well just start stacking with Time Warp. We'll get rid of Mirror Guard, I guess. Throw this down. I guess we can reload even. Yeah, okay, you know what we're not going to draw with that? We're going to play the Time Warp and go Zen. Purge that. Play that. Okay, what the 10 stacks? What? Why is it 10? What is happening? That's so confusing. It's up to 10 now. Someone explain. If I lose, it's because of the 16 health. Yeah, dude. If I lose by 16 health, there's no way. There's no way. We have such a good deck right now. Okay, let's put away this. Put this on top. Draw with the beads here. It's a future strike turn, so I guess we might be able to kill you. There's a chance. A lot of overcharge, too. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're dead. Get you back. Alright, keeping the garbage to a minimum is going to be really nice here. Because we do have some draw discard, but, you know, we need to see the same card over and over again, so anything that reduces our consistency at that sucks a lot. Okay, it's still a Future Strike turn. It's going to be Future Strike turn forever. We got Circular Logic back. We don't need you? Because we're going to get Rage here. Keep going with the circular. Pitch those. Feeling pretty good about this one. Get him out of here. Look at that. That was fast. And we didn't even actually have to take advantage of the extra random turns, right? From Time Warp. Or did we get one random extra turn? I don't know. It's not like I could have not, right? Couldn't have avoided that. I'm definitely going to have to let Josh know about that, though. That needs to get fixed. This hand is not great, but it could become pretty good if we draw stuff off path. Okay, persist is something. There we go. 1,000 Fists. Better future. That's more like it. Get rid of you and you. Throw down the Time Warp. Get our Rage, hit for 240. Better future back. And, I don't know, get that upgraded. Draw another card. It is actually important here. The spell's about to come off. The beads are ready, so we'll purge this. And we'll hold on to this because he drops off debuffs faster. 4 stacks of fatigue. Not concerned about the damage at all. Okay. We want to go in with abilities here because we're going to draw and we would reshuffle if we don't circular logic first. Actually, well, that's not true because this card goes to the bottom of the deck. I still think it's going to be abilities here. So we can just start with circular. Play this because we need the Vuln. Then goes in with this. Ditching this stuff. And then we'll do this trick again, right? No, actually, we'll save the spell, because we have the circular right now. So this way we can get the foresight on it. We'll spell it next time. Take some overcharge. This thing's ready to go too. There should be a breeze. I mean, Echo Wall just doesn't matter in this fight, really. It just doesn't. Definitely want to use these guys to get rid of the Haunted. So we can get our double triggers here. And we drew the Circuit Logic again, but we can even go, like, quadruple on it this time. Because, like, we can play that, put this back, play that, draw it, ditch, ditch, play that, circular again, and get it next turn. I do not care about taking 6 damage. Score does not matter to me. No way. Oh no, we do have a way to draw cards with Path, so the Better Future is good. So we can put away this, I guess. Still have plenty of overcharge, but why not get some more? Back. Plus this, I guess. Okay. Probably about ready to cash in this draw potion, or the patience potion, rather. I think this is the turn probably to use the patience potion. Opposing force is better than stability this time. Yeah, we'll go ahead and crack this. Get this guy again. There we go, we'll take another 6. It really doesn't matter. Here comes the big draw. That's what I'm talking about. I will take some rage, please. And you're out of here. How many times can we even do this to him? We're out of Zen. Better Future for it again. Oh, whoops, I got double triggered. Well, that's all we can do. I forgot about the double trigger. And we almost got him with She, too. So long, Mr. Void Man. Easy peasy. Yeah, we crushed him, dude. Pretty good stuff. Pretty good stuff. And none of our relics were honestly all that crazy. We didn't use the red pills very often, which when I picked them up, I identified that that was a concern. But, you know, even if they only triggered a few times, like turn one, it was a really big deal that it triggers turn one, because that let us kill the dude who was trying to give us garbage. Or, I mean, in this case, turn two, because we had stealth on turn one, but you get the idea. The Soul Sieve was a really good choice. The Echo Cloak ended up being really good, too. Echo Cloak counter, that was fun. And, yeah, I think that's... Gotta fix the time warp bug. Gotta say something about that. Path to Enlightenment was really good. Very cool card, I like it a lot.